In this week's Admired by an Idiot, I'd like to talk about a young actor called Will Merrick. Will has worked for us three times, once in our production of The Ghost Train by Arnold Ridley at the Royal Exchange Theatre in Manchester, and then a couple of developments with us for The Strange Tale of Charlie Chaplin and Stan Laurel and The Winchester, The Gun That Won the West. I really like Will as an actor. I find him really fascinating. You can't take your eyes off him, really. He has that brilliant combination of intelligence and instinct, and not all actors combine that. He's equally as comfortable with the script or improvising. I remember when he played Charles Murdoch, the young newlywed for us in The Ghost Train. And The Ghost Train was written in the 1920s. It's an old English play by Arnold Ridley. And I remember saying, particularly to the younger actors in the company, you have to embrace this style. It's a long way from naturalism. But I also wanted to, in the production, combine the kind of horror and scares of the story genuinely with some real robust comedy, both physical and verbal. And it meant a real commitment to that style. And Will did that. He never parodied it. He never sent it up. He played it with a real straight bat. And as a result, when it was funny, it was really funny. Likewise, I remember in the Winchester R&D, where we were working a scene where the news BBC News anchorman Hugh Edwards was interviewing the 19th century head of the American Army, General Ulysses E. Grant, and his horse in the studio. And Will played the general with the horse with him there in the studio. And again, he pitched it perfectly. He really played it like he was on a contemporary news item defending the policy of the army. And as a result, it was fantastically funny. So he's a smart actor. Now, obviously, he's had success, you know, on TV and film. I particularly liked him when he played the snooker player Steve Davis. I thought he was fantastic. But what I admire about him, and particularly, you know, for his generation, he's not one of these actors who just hangs around. He's clearly interested in writing and doing his own thing. But for us, he's a perfect idiot. And I'd have him back like a shot.